Hello, I'm Chris Maguire, and I've got another Hey Chris question. This time I've been asked, Hey Chris, what is an area you see most bands failing at? That's a very good question. I'd have to say the area that I see most bands failing at is promotion slash marketing. A lot of bands don't realise that if you want to share your music to as many people, you have to expose your music to a lot of people. It's the same method as marketing and promoting. You have to think of your band as a business. Whether your goals are monetary, to try to make a living out of it, or just to purely share it with as many people as you possibly can, it all comes down to promotion and marketing. I see so many bands failing at this, and there is absolutely no excuse to be bad at this, especially in today's climate. Your phone is an advertising company. You have everything at your disposal to get the word out about your band and about your music to as many people as possible. It has been never better to have something to share to somebody else or something to sell to somebody else. It has never been easier to be able to put it in front of a lot of people. But so many bands are failing at this. I am gobsmacked by the number of bands that are together and don't yet have a Facebook page. Like, seriously, come on. It's like the number one step. You come up with a band name, you start a Facebook page. One really great guy that I look up to when it comes down to using social networking and social media to its full advantage is a guy named Gary Vaynerchuk. I'll leave a link up so you can follow him on all the social networking platforms. He is a master at it. He uses it for himself. He's got his own advertising company. He takes care of some very, very big brands for all their social networking things. Their advertising things. He really knows his stuff. I absorb as much as I can from him, so definitely check it out. Gary Vaynerchuk is great. As it comes to social networking, be on all of them. Be on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and be prolific about engaging with as many people as you possibly can. If you start to get a bit of a following, really reply to all your fans. If somebody gives you a bit of credit, reply back to them. It's going to mean the world to them. So many bands and musicians don't do this. Once you start getting a following, that's the golden goose. You have to worship your golden goose, worship your fans. Really take the time out to give them whatever they sort of want and really connect with them. The more they connect with you, the more they're going to buy from you, the more they're going to see your concerts. At the end of the day, it's all about hustle. It may take a little bit of time, so don't give social networking, say, 3 months and go, oh, this isn't working. The first 1,000 fans are the hardest to get. Once you get that first 1,000 fans, then that will quickly get a roll into 2,000. And then 2,000 will quickly become 5,000. Now 5,000 will grow up to 10,000, and then so on and so forth. Getting that first 1,000 fans is where you want to work at the most. So that's the number one area I see most bands failing at. So hopefully you got something from that. Well, I've been Chris. You've been fantastic. If you do have any questions, just send them through to chris@musiccavern.com.au. Cheers. Thanks.